Last night, I heard about the allegations that was brought forward by members of staff in Blute House, the official residence of the First Minister of Scotland, to Alex Salmond, that accused him of sexual harassment in 2013 when he was the First Minister of Scotland. I want to talk about what's been happening in Scottish politics and why it's a total bloody mess. I want to have a deep discussion about the allegations and why it is an important time. But before we go into that, I want to give a background on my experiences in Scottish politics and my opinions on Alex Salmond before the situation kicked off last night. Politically, I still do think that he did a lot of good in government. I admired the way he abolished the bedroom tax in Scotland, protected free tuition fees, abolished prescription charges for the NHS, and resisted Tory plans for privatisation of our services in Scotland. He could have gone further. I don't believe that scrapping commitments to abolish the council tax was a smart thing to do, and he proposed cutting corporation tax before that plan was shelved. Having said that, I believe that the women coming forward with these allegations complaints must be dealt with seriously, and just because these complaints were made about a famous politician, they cannot be swept under the rug. There is a chance that Alex Salmond could be innocent. However, there is a chance that Alex Salmond could be guilty. However, there is a chance that Alex Salmond could be innocent, but we will never know the answer to this question unless there is a fair and unbiased review that is taken into examining the entire situation. Historically, there have been times where men in certain positions of power have abused that power and twisted it to suit their own ends, and that culture is what we need to be addressing. We need to be addressing that the culture that is sexual assault and the fact that it actually happens, especially to women. Power and the position of responsibility gives us a massive advantage over other people, and it is quite easy for that power to be abused, which leads to actions like sexual assault. I know very few details about the personal case against Alex Salmond, which is why I'm refusing to take sides. I think it's hugely important for all of us to get the full picture and full details before we start defending or condemning people. I find it hugely disturbing that supporters of Alex Salmond and the SNP and the Yes campaign are just jumping in to defend him without even having a full picture of the situation and without even taking into consideration what the women are saying about this. This is the reason that sometimes women do not come forward with legitimate claims of sexual assault, because they believe that they won't be believed, and this is the stigma that we have created as a society, especially when these women are making claims about public figures, massive politicians, which makes it easier for someone to get away with this if they have a position of responsibility and power. It is hugely important that we create a society where women feel they are comfortable to come forward with allegations against people when they feel safe and are not stigmatised. Isn't that what we should be addressing as new stories about these allegations against Alex Salmond come to light? I think that is what we should be addressing too. I think Nicola Sturgeon, the current First Minister of Scotland and the leader of the SNP, did a fantastic job in handling the situation, hammering home the point that these allegations should be taken seriously and refusing to give her undying support to her friend and colleague almost 30 years before full details come to light. This is how we should be handling these situations. She is an example to all of us. This will be a really hard time for the SNP, party members, and of course Nicola Sturgeon personally. In a statement that was put forward by Alex Salmond on his Twitter page, he announced his intention to fight these allegations. He also announced his intention to take legal action on the Scottish Government over the way they have investigated these claims of sexual harassment, dating back to his time as FM. I think we need to understand that supporters of a political party don't really know the people behind the political persona that they have given to the public. It's extremely hard to tell just by looking at someone if they are capable of sexual assaulting people, because when you think about it, rapists, people who commit acts of sexual violence and assault, they aren't some alien invention. They are normal human beings who inhabit our society, and this needs to be known. There have been suggestions of why victims of this personal attack would come forward now if the actions happened in 2013, but this just goes back to the stigma that women are mostly not believed and don't feel safe to come forward with allegations about a public figure. If they are true or fake, it hinders the entire women's movement. We haven't created a society where women feel comfortable in coming forward with these horrible acts that happen to them, especially if the people they are making the claims about are famous politicians like Alex Salmond. It's just not something that women feel comfortable to do at the time. What would really help the women's rights movement, and what would really help removing a lot of stigma from sexual assault, is that when any victim, male or female, comes forward with an accusation, is that everything is taken seriously and they are not automatically assumed to be lies, and they are not automatically assumed to be telling the truth. I think every single claim needs to be taken seriously and needs to be given their time and examination. That would help remove a lot of stigma on this sort of action. So in conclusion, I hope these allegations actually do come to a conclusion, and in the upcoming weeks and months we actually know the full details, and if Alex Salmond is innocent, we move on, and if he is guilty, then he faces repercussions, and I think that is the ultimate conclusion that I can come to. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.